New rules proposed for foreign investors would, among other things, turn off the tap for overseas water bottling companies. So, are such changes really in our national interest, or would they ultimately make our country poorer? Joining us with divergent views on the subject are New Zealand First Minister Tracey Martin in Wellington this morning and National Party MP Mark Mitchell here in Auckland. Good morning to you both.
Morning, Anna. Morning.
I guess the first question is, Tracey, for you. What, I want to have a chat about water bottling in a moment there, but we've seen some news out this morning in the media about the intervention in early education for young children. $21 million went towards that, but yet the early intervention delay has got worse for these young children. Was that not enough money to get this problem solved? It was a pretty strong promise.
Well, yes, so it was $21.5 million that went in out of last year's budget on top of what was the existing budget. But ultimately, throwing more money at this problem is not going to fix it. We've had a 21% increase since 2013 in behavioural issues, 15% increase in communication issues. What we've got is we've got more children with more need.
But you did throw more money at it.
We did, and that's why it's not the only solution. That's why the learning support delivery model being rolled out across New Zealand by the end of 2019... The learning support coordinators working with clusters and kahui ako that include ECE providers. These are some of the steps that we are taking to change the system that you just can't keep pumping more money into.
So what do you say then to parents who looked at that promise and thought, finally something's going to happen?
Well, it did happen, $21.5 million. It just, what,
yeah,
it, what we realised...
Yeah, but the delay got worse. Didn't stagnate. That, it actually got, the delay got worse. It went from 74 days to 100.
That's right. So what I'm saying is the promise that we would put more money in to what is the current system was kept. What it shows and what we knew was that after years of no workforce planning, it'll take 3 years to train more psychologists, 5 years to train more speech language therapists. We have to have a better plan than just throwing more money at it, and that's what we're attempting to do through the learning support delivery model, the learning support coordinators, and expanding on that workforce planning.
All right, Mark, a bit of a hint there that it takes a few years to solve this problem, which might say that it's not just money being thrown at it. Any comment on that?
Well, the problem is that they set the expectations, and what they did is they promised more money, and they said the expectation was that that would fix the problem. It clearly hasn't. The problem's getting worse. They didn't have a plan, and this is what happens when you don't have a plan. You can't just throw money at stuff. You can't have untargeted spending.
It's just about hard to be critical, though, isn't it, when Tracey's point is that it takes 3 years or so, that actually it's a problem she's trying to solve from a hangover.
I don't just want to be critical. We want to try and find a solution and fix it, but actually you will be critical when the situation's becoming worse and not better. So they're throwing money at it. You can't just throw money at stuff. You actually have to have a plan. You have to be very targeted. You have to
know
what your outcomes are and what you want to achieve. And quite simply, the minister said in her opening statement, we just threw money at it and it hasn't worked. I mean, 18 months in, that's just not good enough.
Right, you're promising there's a plan there, Tracey?
Well, no, there is a plan. The Learning Support Action Plan is rolling out across New Zealand now. But quite rightly, as you have pointed out, 9 years. This didn't happen just overnight. 9 years. I'm trying to fix 9 years worth of neglect.
Well, I hope you don't need 9 years to fix it. That's my only issue there. All right, overseas investment rules. Simon Bridges, Mark, saying that this will be New Zealand closed for business. That's a bit of a big call there.
Well, there's a risk because there's the perception around it. I think it's a bit counterintuitive when on one hand you're saying that the government wants to reduce compliance and red tape. I think that's a very good thing. But on the other hand, they're saying that we're going to introduce a new national interest test. And no one's certain exactly what that's going to mean or how that's going to roll out. It will create uncertainty. And at the moment, we have seen that in terms of foreign investment, we are spooking that foreign capital. And actually, we need it. For our economy to be healthy and to grow, we actually need that good foreign investment.
Tracey, we did just hear, Jack did an interview just then, and that uncertainty is actually cause for concern. While it can be seen as scaremongering, uncertainty is a real risk here for businesses looking at New Zealand as an investment proposal. What's your response to that?
Well, first of all, this is a discussion document that's been put out by Treasury, so that's the first thing. So anybody who has some issues can actually put them into that discussion. But at the end of the day, I suppose, a New Zealand government should be governing for the benefit of New Zealanders. All the decisions they make should be based on what is best for the future of New Zealanders. So all we're talking about here is, one, we obviously need foreign investment. We want to create an environment that is good for them, but also good for New Zealanders. It's fairly simple.
So you're going to have a word in that discussion document there, Mark? You're going to be putting your 2 cents in?
No, I think that's a very nice catchphrase to have, but the reality of it is the test is, how's the economy doing? And if our economy is going backwards, then for New Zealanders, that's actually a bad thing. That affects every part of our life.
But it's something you might not be able to measure. That's the problem, right? It's uncertainty, but that doesn't mean it's a bad thing. It just means there's a level of uncertainty in that ability for the government to make decisions on a case-by-case basis. Well, may not turn out badly.
Effectively, what this is trying to give ministers more power and more control, OK?
Effectively.
And what we need to be looking at very carefully is whether we are still in a nation that has been seen to open, an open nation, an open economy, that will attract good foreign investment. Historically, we've been very good at doing that. We've got some of the toughest tests in the OECD around foreign investment. We're very, very careful in how we approach this. But introducing a new national test, while at the same time, national interest test, while at the same time we're going to reduce red tape and compliance, the two actually don't sit well together.
Tracey, you're promising this will not be New Zealand closed for business?
No, it's not New Zealand closed for business. I mean, this government has done more trade deals. We're constantly talking trade across the planet. But what we are saying is that when you make a decision about a strategic asset in New Zealand that you intend to sell offshore, that you look at the long-term future of it. And your article earlier talked a lot about water. So there are things that you might sell today, you need to look at the consequences long term, and that's part of what this discussion is about.
All right, I've got one last very important question. Hot cross buns, raisins, fruit peel in them or not?
I love raisins and hot cross buns, but there's one caveat to that, is I like the big juicy ones, not the small sort
of
the hard
salt. Wow, now we're going down the rabbit
hole. You've actually got five boxes sitting out there, you guys. I don't know if you realise that.
I'm pretty sure Daniel's already loaded four of them.
There's three boxes there.
All right, Tracey, you get the last word, hot cross buns?
I don't like hot cross buns.
Tracey!
Sorry, I don't like them.
Okay.
Cream buns.
Happy Easter, Tracey. Thank you for joining us. Political panel this morning. Tracey Martin from New Zealand First and Mark Mitchell. Thanks for coming in, guys.
Wow. Yeah.